was it? It's interesting because when I met you again many years after that at the IBM studio, and I was like, oh my god, you know Chicken Center, we must go for a drink. But by then you had stopped drinking.
2015.
Conscious decision?
Sometimes
it's health.
My drinking led me to loss of conscious.
No, sometimes health also. Like, you know, you've got
not health. Just behavior. I've said this 100 times. What happened is that when I was in my 20s, being a single male, since I had left, Friday night I would drink, I would sing, I'd come back, sing Italian opera, naked on my dining table. My mother would wake up in the morning and tell me, Joe, what you did? And they'd be giggling. Everyone thought it was really cute.
Yeah.
This crazy kid. And everybody thought it was really cute. Then your stories got a little worse. Elvis tie is on my car. My dad goes to walk the dog in the morning, finds a tie on the car mirror. Still cute, funny. But then I got married, I had kids, now I'm like a grandfather. I become a creepy old, you know, getting into fights and, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of people stop talking to me, which I thank them for now, because I don't want to be social.
Yeah.
But, and I don't know what happened. So obviously I've done something to them while drinking.
Yeah.
You know, after some time my body of work spoke for itself, because
yeah,
a lot of people are now not friendly, you know, avoiding you. And all my boys in the gym would be cleaning up my act all the time. You know, like I remember, I urinated on somebody. Okay, and obviously a fight should have broken out. But luckily, I have a lot of people there, so
yeah,
you know, nothing happened. So I got a lot of protection, I thought, which I didn't deserve.
Yeah.
And these boys are younger than me, you know. These
yeah,
young kids and football kids are putting me in the car, sending me home, like the little jewel that I am. I was so kid, 17.
Yeah.
But now I'm older than them, I'm still
yeah,
behaving 17.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like irony. I remember once in the toilet somewhere, we had a punching thing to break something, and we broke the whole panel. I mean, and I was in my 30s or 40s by then.
Yeah, then you don't want to be that guy anymore.
Yeah, so I'm not really like that, you know.
So you just completely went cold turkey?
No, I just, after many months of just sitting over it, I took 1 week off.
Yeah.
I only drank Friday night, or once a week or once in 2 weeks. And then I took 2 weeks off, then I took 3 weeks off. In a month I managed. Then I never stopped. Every Friday, I would, because for so many years I'm classic conditioned for Friday.
Yeah.
And I've got this slightly very Germanic mentality. I do everything like, just flows, it has to flow on time, because I go berserk. So Kunal and I used to drink, we used to start at 7:30.
Right.
So if we had parties in my house and all in the 90s, at 10:30 guests would come, I was the most drunk.
Yeah.
I had broken glasses in the house and all that, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know why. Once I remember throwing glasses down from the window with two of my friends. What if somebody died? You
yeah,
know? We were just throwing glasses
yeah,
with juvenile. Oh, I've done terrible things, we have no idea.
Ah. But you should still come for the chicken though.
Chicken Center, they call us Baba. 2015, I was 42, 43 or something.
Still call you Baba, yeah.
Baba. And they know my drink, which is like the straw inside the glass with Diet Coke, no ice. And then after two drinks, one ice and vodka. Okay, so my drink was very different from anybody else's, so that was fine. But if I brought anybody there, even once, they would remember the order for life.
Yeah,
what
that's
talent,
that's
guys,
always been, you know,
great,
for the longest time, that place used to be open with the shutter half down till 4
yeah,
5
yeah,
in the morning.
Yeah, all that.
And based on how much of a regular you were, you could stay, you know. And I remember at one point I was such a regular that I was there till 5 in the morning. And then I realized, I don't want to be
a regular. You don't misbehave, I don't have a problem with the drinking. The misbehaving as you grow older is a problem.
Yeah.
Also don't mind, behave 20, you know, you should let your hair down, you should have some bad stories,
yeah,
it's fine. Two things, don't get fight with people because,
yeah,
you know, that's just disgusting at the end.
Yeah.
Why don't you justify it the next day?
Yeah.
Why do you fight with the guy? You're drunk, the guy was in your way or something, you know, the boys tell me later what I did, you know, like, I can't
yeah,
tell you. All those, you can't explain it, it's too infantile. Like, yes,
yeah,
you can explain.
I get sad if I drink too much. So I'm like, I'm only a danger to myself. Like, I'm not an injured to anybody else when I'm drunk.
Oh, yeah, your stories are different.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
So I think it's now. But you know what? It was so interesting. For the longest time, I quit drinking for about 2.5 years. This is
yeah,
around when I went from chops to thin.
Yeah.
And
well, was it to do with the mental depression thing?
It was. Yeah, it was also to do with the depression. Because, you know, alcohol can, if you're already in a sad place and then you drink, then you end up in a way worse
one
place.
Way out of that, never look at the bill.